gender balance of A-level physics has been an issue for many years. The number of girls taking A-level physics is around 20%, and it's been that way for the last 30 years. Our previous research kind of hints that maybe it's something to do with schools as a whole.
We've had real fluctuation in numbers. Good years where we've had six girls, we've had bad years where we've had one, which is the current situation in year 13. Our project officer came to talk to the governors, to the science department, and actually took the opportunity to do some whole school training as well. She's come and run CPD for teachers. She's worked with small groups of girls, building confidence, building resilience. If you don't have the support of the senior leadership, I don't think that any initiative would get off the ground.
It is very personalised to every single school. For us, it's an issue with boys dominating practical equipment, boys dominating the teacher's attention, and that's one of the issues that we've got across the school. In terms of gender balance from the other side of the coin, we're looking at how boys may be stereotyped, not want to take a subject because they may be perceived as less masculine. Ruislip was involved with Drayson, and we are going on to doing the Opening Doors project, so we are really making it a whole school issue.
It's been really effective in raising the issue of gender and the effect that that can have in schools, and making sure that people across the organisation understand the impacts that gender can have. The emphasis on gaining evidence that the Institute collects and uses to inform what programmes are used and how interventions with schools are carried out lends a real level of credibility. I think the next step is making sure that it has impact across a wider range of schools. I really wish I'd done A-level physics.